Hello, I'm Nick Pryke and you're watching Meet the Boss TV. In this episode, why if sharing is caring, the risks have never been greater. Collaboration is nothing new in the business arena, but as the tide brings to shore a host of new file sharing platforms, one thing is clear, the risks have never been greater. I spoke with ING's Olivier Kerckhoff to find out more, starting with how he thinks the landscape has shifted.
From a corporate perspective, what I see is that the consumers are becoming part of the workforce as well as the end customers. So the IT, at least for financial industry, which was usually reserved for the real experts, let's say people in underwriting or claims, is now becoming much more accessible, and it goes beyond just email. So I feel that the accessibility makes it kind of cross the borders where I think the issues start to arise, that people are expecting the same in the office as they're getting at home. They actually expect the same at home as they could get in the office. So the expectation of people is to be able to cross those borders, and they don't see it as a separate thing anymore. I think from that perspective, the borders are shading. And in the future, I think we either need to make those borders clear. So there's going to be some incidents around privacy. There's going to be some incidents about data leaks, which will say, okay, guys, we're going to completely separate those two, or we're going to have to do a lot more data classification.
So what do you see as the real dangers of those employee expectations then?
The employees are carrying around data, which is, let's say, risky data. So the high-risk data is there. And they're just carrying it around in any device they have. So, and they might not be aware of this risk, or they might not be aware of the fact that even their high executive, they have this iPad, they forced IT to be able to see their mail on the iPad and read the attachments. They have no idea that the attachments stay on the device, and they don't know how easy it is to hack an iPad, and they leave it somewhere. So it becomes much more easier to get into those data if it's on even a physical device. Let alone that, of course, we originally had users also using Dropbox and other items, especially working with external companies who want to be able to work on their own PCs. You can't track what's happening if it's moved to Dropbox or anything like that.
So how do ING track their data across the workforce? How do they proactively bridge the gap between security and usability? Well, according to Olivier, it all starts with dropping the hardware.
The first thing we did, obviously, was to the initial secure and compliant actions to shut everything down. So we can't use USB, you can't use your CD. All websites that refer to storage or even email, personal email accounts are locked. So that was the initial response, which resulted in quite some resistance. So it was opened up a little bit. But at the same time, I think the better effort was to also provide, let's say, alternatives. So there is a webmail possibility for your ING mails, and there is even a full home desktop solution, a VDI type solution that would be able to just be used from a web browser. So you're providing the office space in a more secure way that kind of bridges the need to have both. The challenge still comes in the people want to bring in their own devices, or they want to read it on tablets. That's where still the challenges are. I think we're kind of in the middle, both culturally as well as technically. Of moving to, allowing these access to systems and educating employees and still being able to control it. And I think that's also a balance. If you have 30,000 people working for you in a company, it's going to be a challenge to educate them all. But it's also going to be a challenge to try and close up everything because the incidents will always be there. Because if someone is knowledgeable enough and is intentionally trying to get data out, I think it's always possible. And at the same time, if you're able to value your data, you value the risks, you can also value the effort or cost you make in protecting that comparing just to making it available.
Mm. So who do you think makes the first step there? Is it the culture? Is it the technology? Or do they really have to be hand in hand as they move forward?
I think it's like any change program, it's hand in hand. So once you're implementing this, and that's actually not working well usually, closing up the USB connections, making things less available, it didn't really go well hand-in-hand with the communication. It's quite different from introducing a new application or a new system towards the employees where they get an educated, they get training, and that's basically what should happen on this as well. And even though we could do that kind of training to do it to the whole mass, where only a few people are using it at a certain point and they get introduced to it later. The challenge becomes to how do you find the point where someone starts to use it and then can give them just basic training about the sensitivity of data and then actually have them either make a choice to use this with a little bit of less security or not use it, or maybe have the alternative of using like a very secure webmill, which offers less functionality, like not being able to download attachments or something like that.
So obviously you're never going to rid the world of the likes of Dropbox and Google Drive. But just as Microsoft is trying to do with its Surface tablet and BYOD, is there an element of reverse engineering that this kind of consumer-inspired platform into the corporate arena, do you think?
What we see in one of our countries is actually implementing now the choose-your-own-device, because we have the exchange standard for our email, and with Windows 8, actually, it's secure enough to meet our regulatory requirements. So they say, if you want to use email and agenda and whatever we offer with Windows, you have to choose a Windows device, and this is one of them. We'll install it for you, and then it's secure enough. For me, Dropbox is something, especially after the incidents, that's not part of the business environment. So, and honestly, I think it's relatively easy to block once you still own the device as a company. And once you give away data to the customer's device without the control, without the sandbox environment or anything like that, yeah, you lose it. And Dropbox, yeah, if it's Dropbox, Google Drive, or just persons sending emails to each other, you lost the control. So for me, Dropbox by itself doesn't provide that much of an issue, just as long as you provide a alternative, not only for the employees themselves, but also for the externals we're working with or any other professional relationships.
And it's precisely these other professional relationships that the business needs to protect in order to kickstart new collaborative efforts. So how does this fit in over at ING?
We have SharePoint, basically, that's as one of the standards. It's not that convenient to use for everyone. So I think basically something that like Dropbox works well, and it's easy to add it, and there are alternatives that are more secure and that can push you into the cloud with encrypted data, so whatever Dropbox will lose or anyone else would lose will be encrypted anyway, which I think is an easy alternative to go to the cloud. Honestly, I don't think our regulatory bodies are ready for that yet. If you say cloud, they run away. So I think that's still a challenge for introducing those items. They're going to look at each implementation separately, but it's at least open for discussion rather than they're just going to run away. I think that's a good next step to do, to show that type of technologies which combine the user friendliness and the recognition of what the people are already using with something that's actually allowed in the company. The challenge, of course, is if you're using it at home, you're going to have a couple of gigabytes, maybe terabytes of data. If you look at the company, it is exponentially that much. There's tons and tons of data, projects, reports, everything is there. But it's very difficult to reuse it because it's not very structured.
And on the topic of what's missing, I wrapped up by asking Olivier what he thought was getting in the way of accelerating file sharing standards. His answer? Well, if you're a regulator, you might want to listen closely.
I think the biggest thing I would like to remove is the gap between, let's say, current reality and let's say, the reality that the regulators and maybe even internal risk departments are living in. So I really should think that these regulators get more technology savvy, they're more onto innovation, more onto discussions with the larger vendors to make sure that technology will meet their requirements, it will be in control still, rather than having this discussion continuously internally and taking, as a financial institute, being only years after the fact able to implement something which was there already years ago, didn't really change that much security-wise, but it took just a long time to convince regulators to accept it.